you turn on your portable MP3 device to listen to your favorite podcast. You expect a witty introduction from the announcer, but he doesn't have one. Instead, he just does this. You're beyond the 50-foot nerds.
Hello.
Right, okay. I've got it working now, so this one's recording.
Okay, that's good. That's what we like to hear. Everyone's a winner, baby. That's the truth. And a hot chocolate.
What?
You never heard that song? Everyone's a winner, baby. That's the truth.
Oh, maybe.
Yeah, it's by a band called Hot Chocolate.
Oh, okay. Whenever I think of that, I always think of that sweet light chocolate. You know, the
sweet boy. What's the other one they sing as well? Is
brings me so much joy. Whoa! And the video was like all the. Oh no, wait, that was a different thing. I was gonna say like the.
It's some chocolate girl on top of a bus or something in it. It's weird.
Yeah.
Sweet light chocolate. Yeah.
And then there was around the same time there was that other one where it was all like it was the cardboard woman, and there was all the cardboard people dancing and shit.
I don't remember that. But what was the other hot chocolate song? It was in the Full Monty.
I am gonna sex you up.
No, oh god, I'm gonna have to Google it because it's winding me up now. Come on. Where are we? Oh yeah, I believe in miracles. Where are you from? You sexy thing. That one.
Oh, I didn't know they did. I always just presumed
and
that was
starting
James
with
Brown.
A kiss. Never thought it would come to this.
That was just
starting presumed. With a kiss.
I always just presumed that was James Brown. No, wait, Tom Jones.
No, Tom Jones sang "You Can Leave Your Hat On." Yeah, that's in the Full Monty as well. That's the last song they stripped to. Because they come out as security guards wearing hats, and the last thing they take off is hats. So, yeah. Anyway, he's dead, the man who sung that song.
Oh, is he?
So, yeah. Yeah, dead in 2015.
Oh, no.
Met him many times. My dad was...
Tom Jones did sing
Sexy
Thing.
My dad
was a thing.
Huge... Wait, did he?
Yeah. I just searched it. Tom Jones, You Sexy Thing. And it's like, I believe in miracles. Where are you from, You Sexy Thing?
Well, maybe he did a cover of it. I don't know, but...
Or the hot
what
chocolate
year did
was...
Tom Jones release that?
I'm just trying to find it.
Because Hot Chocolate was 1975. God, whoever looks at my Google history, Tom Jones, Sexy Thing.
I searched Sexy Thing, Tom Jones.
Right, okay. You Sexy Thing is a song recorded by the British group Hot Chocolate. Okay. It was... Later covered, let's see, cover versions, covered by, let's see, Study of Phonics. No, I don't see any Tom Jones versions. No, it was written by the guy from Hot Chocolate, so. You lie.
I'm just trying to find his singles.
Pourquoi, Andy? Pourquoi?
Where's his discography out there?
Are we sung a billion songs? We're never going to find it. I don't know. Unless YouTube gives me anything. That's Hot Chocolate.
Mm.
That's hot chocolate.
Hmm.
I don't see any Tom Jones. Now, what are you eating?
A donut.
You don't know what? What don't you know?
What I'm eating?
You don't know what you're eating?
No, I just picked up some something random off the stuff. Shit, where's the cat gone?
I'm too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love. Love's going to leave.
Come on, Andy.
Hey!
Get your shirt off, shave your head.
Like, one of the first... I've got a recording of the very first song
it's
I ever played.
Time.
I've got a recording of the first show I ever played live, right? And I actually put one of these. No, it was of me singing "Roots, Bloody Roots" by Sepultura, and adding a verse of this song into it.
I'm too sexy for my shirt.
Yeah, so yeah. It's like I'm too sexy for my shirt. Just like over.
And I'm too sexy for my cat. Too sexy for my cat. No, my shorts and my hat. I don't know.
It was just like the. my shorts
I'm
and my
a
hat.
You know what I mean. And I do what they got on the catwalk.
It was only the first verse that I'm too sexy for my shirt. The too sexy for my shirt bit. So it was like, I'm too sexy for me. Too sexy for my roots. Bloody roots.
I'm too sexy for your nan. Too sexy for your nan. Your aunt and your dad. I don't know.
I'm too sexy for my tongue. Too sexy for my tongue, my heart and my lungs. Ah!
And Sean Young.
Oh, the other day, someone at work, someone was saying like, "Oh, you're a big fan of that band Five, aren't you?" And I tried to explain that time that we were sat there like overanalyzing Five lyrics, like
Slam Dunk in the Funk.
Yeah, like when we were just sat there, just like talking, we're just like reading them in posh accents, like Slam Dunk the Funk.
Well, this is
get
what
on
happens
up when you've got that
know.
Feeling.
When we all know that Five will make you get down now. Mm. Yeah. So, you know. If you don't know. Inspector Gadget. Speaking of Inspector Gadget, I once spent a good hour or so googling trying to find the face of Dr. Claw. Now, there was an action figure of Dr. Claw released many years
ago.
I've
seen that. Where it's like
have his face on it.
Yeah,
but it's never been shown on the actual program.
Mm. No, it hasn't.
No, he's very short and very fat because he was able to easily take the place of Father Christmas in Inspector Gadget's Saves Christmas.
Oh yeah, forgot about that. Did we watch that?
No, we didn't. It's on a Nostalgia Critic.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, of course. We need to watch it.
Because he fumes over the fact that it's not Cree Summer doing the voice of
Dr. Claw.
Penny.
Oh yeah, yeah.
No, Penny. Cree Summer doing the voice of Dr. Claw.
I'll get you next time, Gadget.
Yeah.
I've got Gadget.
Brain like.
Have you seen the new series?
No. I cannot be asked. I believe it's Maurice LaMarche doing the voice, isn't it?
I just know that the... He
played Inspector Gadget in the pre-Matthew Broderick live-action appearance, the one and only appearance that was before the Disney movie. And it was as a guest appearance on the Super Mario Brothers Super Show.
Oh!
Where,
that is real.
Yeah, where Maurice LaMarche appeared in person as Inspector Gadget and came to visit Mario and Luigi because he needed their help. And Mario was played by a former professional wrestler called Captain Lou Albano. But then there was also another episode where Mario and Captain Lou Albano needed Mario's help, so he met himself.
Okay.
Not even messing, this really happened.
I've just found a picture of the TV show appearance.
It's a bit odd.
Yeah.
So.
And then just random footage, like random pictures of like someone doing art of Mario as Inspector Gadget.
Because of course.
Mm. And then for some reason, Buzz with an arm missing.
Mario. Buzz.
Yeah, Buzz with an arm missing.
But why?
And why? Inspector Gadget in the place of Professor Oak in the Pokemon game just says underneath, touch the button on the middle of the Pokeball if you'd please. And it's just Inspector Gadget stood there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go, Gadget Pokeball.
Someone has just drawn. I'm just looking at this other fan art of.
Why are you looking at fan art of bloody Inspector Gadget?
No, I googled Inspector Gadget Mario, Super Mario, and looked in the images to look at the image of Inspector Gadget, and now I'm just marveling at what came up. So there's a picture of.
Well, you do
realize
we're here to do a job.
What's that? Yeah.
Well, you realise we're here to do something today. We're not just here to talk about Mario and Inspector Gadget, although that saying that out loud means that it would be a very good video game.
Well, it's like Gadget versus Mario, and it's like a Mortal Kombat style beat.
Bowser is Dr. Claw.
No, I was imagining it like a Marvel versus Capcom type thing. So it's just like...
Why when there's like three characters in the entirety of friggin' Inspector Gadget? There's Gadget, Brains, Penny, Claw, the Chief.
Yeah, you have Claw. You have the Chief as a thing.
And that's about it.
And then you get like some of the...
The goons.
His hired you get like
goons,
some of the special hired goons from things like the two leprechaun guys from the episode with the Blarney Stone. Or that guy when they were looking for that fucking laser... like statue thing that was hidden behind a waterfall, and there was
I don't remember the intricacies of the episodes. I'll be honest.
And then there was like that guy who, because the dude looking for it was
characters you could have.
Yeah,
you could have Gadget Boy, Heather, the stupid Spider Woman thing, the villain from that series, and you could have the Gadgetinis. There you
okay.
go. Do you not know the Gadgetinis?
Maybe? I don't remember them.
They had a series called Gadget and the Gadgetinis, yeah.
Oh, yeah. One of the characters you could use is just the transforming car. You just get a button to transform and you just run people over.
Oh, no. God, yeah.
No, that would be...
It's got to be voiced by that racial stereotype from the movie.
It's a Disney movie!
Harley, I'm the only black character in this film! And I'm a car! It's a Disney film!
It's a Disney movie!
No black folks to be seen! No, sir! Black folks should be heard and never seen!
Ooh.
Just like the crows from Dumbo! I never did see an elephant fly!
Christ.
Now, excuse me, sir, I've got to take some cotton and sing Zippity Doodah.
Oh, Jesus.
What a wonderful day.
No, like, the character I was thinking of was, it was this, the fella from, some episode where he wore a massive sombrero and he was like a fucking, what do you call the guys in front of the balls that wave the fucking...
Matador.
Yeah, he was like an evil matador. He was like wearing all black. And for some reason, whenever he went brown, around doing like crimes and stealing shit. He was followed by a mariachi band. No, it wasn't that. It was like sort of thing. I just remember him like beating Penny and going "Viva me!" It was weird.
Okay.
And then there was like, and then they found the statue.
My name
the...
is Max Eco.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was one thing that I discovered recently. I didn't realize that the Mache movies were a spin-off of Spy Kids.
I suppose so. Yeah.
Yeah, because the character Machete is their uncle.
Yeah, actually, yeah. You know, although it's a bit confusing as to one of the Spy Kids, the girl from Spy Kids, is in Machete too.
Yeah.
Yeah. But whatever. Anyway, it's not like Robert Rodriguez's movies ever make much sense.
Yeah, true.
Yeah. I mean, Planet Terror, one of my favourite Robert Rodriguez movies, does not make a lick of sense at all.
No, but it's...
But whatever.
It's like...
Yeah, oh no, it's great, Bill. I love it.
Yeah, like, I had to watch that just because I was like, okay, Rose McGowan with a machine gun leg, I'm in.
Well, did you hear about why she's even in Death Proof to be in? Not Death Proof,
Planet Terror.
Planet Terror to begin with. Yeah. It's
no.
to do with all this recent, all to do with this recent, you know, Weinstein thing.
Okay.
Which we won't really go on about. Yeah, because she'd said to Rodriguez about Weinstein and what he's, you know, done to her and all this kind of stuff. And she, what Weinstein had said to her, he said, you know, look, unless you do whatever, you'll never work for my company again. And she told Rodriguez about this, and Rodriguez, yeah, says, okay, yeah. But he doesn't have any say over my movies. I have creative control over everything I do. So even though my films may go out through the Weinstein Company, he's not involved. So if I want to put you in my film, I'll put you in my film. So he gave her the lead role in his film, purely just to fuck with Weinstein.
Nice.
Yeah, in it. And she's in Death Proof as well, obviously. So
yeah, yeah.
She's all over that film. Yeah, just to fuck with Weinstein.
Nice.
So, yeah. Yeah. It does mean that Kev can't do his impressions anymore.
Yeah.
You know, Kev does, yeah. Mm.
Well, doesn't he, most of the time, isn't his... I thought Harvey was the one that he'd fallen out with for a while ago, and...
He is, actually, yeah.
And it was Bob that he did impressions of.
He does
now.
Impressions of both of them.
Yeah.
No, he does impressions of both of them.
He does impressions
Because he kind of made up
like,
with Harvey.
Early... Oh, he does. Right, well, he'll have
Harvey
to just
fell,
go back to...
Harvey fell out with him. Harvey fell out with him over Red State and that whole business Kev wanting to take the movie out on his own. And they kind of made friends again a couple of years ago.
Just found a picture of Gadget Boy and the Gadgetinis.
Oh, God, yeah. Yeah. So are you still Googling Inspector Gadget?
I just on this thing that's like 10 things you didn't know about Inspector Gadget. And number 4 is Inspector Gadget is basically RoboCop. I'm like, what?
He is.
Well, yeah, he is, but, I mean, like, it's also got, like, talking about Mask.
Mask.
Mask! That wasn't the theme. Mask! Oh!
Always riding on a bit an anime. Dippity-dippy, me-to-me, me-to-me. Yeah.
Oh, apparently Doctor Claw's face was revealed on a video game as well.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Okay.
A Super Nintendo game. But obviously it was only like the shit pixely thing.
Yeah.
Inspector Gadget used
to
sell
this...
KFC.
Did you? Okay.
Yeah. There was, like, Inspector Gadget, and he was selling, like, KFC buckets and shit. I like, there's a...
I'm just trying to see...
You tried to see what?
I'm just trying to see if there's any new news about this whole Disney buying Fox thing. It looks like talks have kind of stalled at the moment, so we're not actually sure if it's going ahead or not. But we can always posit, you know, a what if.
Yeah, yeah. No, I figured that was what this was going to be.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We just start the podcast and be like, oh, none of this is certain, so, and then like halfway through it's like, oh.
Because it took us a couple of days to actually get recording in there.
Yeah.
In place. guess what?
Oh, was that theory? Was
that was, yeah. That was me, yeah.
Like talking to the audience, right?
Yeah.
That seems about typical, though. You're like, oh, well, this has happened, so guess what? Me just going, what? And you're just like, not you.
Quiet, you.
Yeah,
well.
Hello there. At this point, you're probably wondering where this episode is that's supposed to be here. Well, that is actually the 20th Century Fox bought by Disney thing special. So if you haven't listened to that, go back and listen to it. That's what goes in the middle here. And otherwise, enjoy the beyond. In What's the Navy. What?
What is wrong with you?
Me? What's wrong with you? What do you mean?
You're wanking up the Hulk for?
It was a reference to earlier.
I know, but still, I referenced something that happened like 5 years ago. You don't see me banging on about it.
I was trying to think of a name, and that was the only thing I could think of.
Well, Hulk 1 Freddie Prinze Jr., but he didn't hear me say that.
Oh.
I don't know.
I could have called myself Gary Baldy again.
Gary Baldy.
I've been Gary Baldy.
I've been a small Italian biscuit.
I'm Steve Guttenberg.
And so's my wife. Hey, guess who's coming to Liverpool?
Steve Guttenberg.
No.
Who?
Zach Galligan.
Who?
Zach Galligan. You may know him better as Bill.
Yeah, I think I know who you mean.
Billy from Gremlins.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He's coming to do a screening and Q&A of Gremlins just in time for Christmas.
Huh.
And the Liverpool Philharmonic Orchestra are doing a screening of Back to the Future with the orchestra doing the music.
Nice.
On New Year's Eve, or rather the day before New Year's Eve, and I really want to go.
I am not surprised.
Oh my God, that's going to be amazing.
Amazing.
Amazing. Imagine Johnny B. Goode. Oh.
What, someone running a violin through distortion?
Hey, Chuck, it's your cousin, Marvin Berry. Don't I do sound you've been looking for? I'm really black.
Now I've got to go be a car.
I'm going to go be and spend it at this car.
Transform.
Damn. Speaking of Transform, I watched Transformers the last night.
Oh, yeah. Terrible.
Fuck me. It was hard going.
Yeah.
You know, every advert for that movie was just like, Optimus Prime versus Bumblebee!
I'm guessing that's the first 30 minutes.
No, it doesn't happen until 2 hours into the film, and it takes place for literally 43 seconds.
Huh.
I'm not even messing.
And then Optimus is like, wait, I should probably...
Optimus goes to Cybertron.
Yeah.
Somehow he makes it there, because at the beginning of the film, you just see him frozen in space, just drifting. So fuck knows how he made it. But he just lands on Cybertron, just as you do, just by chance.
Hmm.
And then there's some kind of like weird female god creature thing there who just goes, oh, you're Optimus Prime, gonna make you evil. And sends him back to Earth.
And right.
Yeah, and she says, and Cybertron's gonna go to Earth as well because we're gonna suck all the energy out of the planet and it's gonna make Cybertron better. Because do you know what?
Who
only
says
one
this?
Planet, this stupid god creature.
Okay.
Because only one planet can live, and Earth is not the real name of Earth. Earth, to Cybertronians, it was always known as dun-dun-dun-dun, Unicron.
What?
Yeah, Earth is Unicron.
How the fuck does that work?
It doesn't.
I am so glad that I didn't go to the cinema to see this, because if so, as soon as he said that, I would have loudly yelled, the fuck?
Yeah. All these big, like, metal horns start growing out of the earth. And apparently that's, like, Unicron. reaching to the sky or something. I don't know. It's stupid.
What? No, that's fucking...
And Optimus Prime comes down to Earth and Bumblebee's all like, oh shit, it's Optimus Prime. He goes, my name is not Optimus Prime. I am Nemesis Prime.
What?
Yeah, and then Bumblebee's voice just works again for no reason. Just goes, Optimus, I'm your busy mate. Bumblebee, don't stab me in the eyes. And then Optimus Prime goes, oh, I'm not a baddie anymore. That's literally it. And then his voice goes back to like radio stuff again.
Huh, that's weird.
I know, stupid. Considering earlier in the film, he's
recorded himself saying different words just in case.
Like Siri.
So it's like, so it's like, hey, Optimus, I'm your friend.
Please, sir, no, what's your sign to? Friend. So, Earlier in the movie, there's a junk trader, or a robot transformer who turns up voiced by Steve Buscemi. Which is really weird, having Steve Buscemi voicing him. You've got John Goodman voicing Hound. And then you've also got the other fellow who was in the first film. He's in it again. He's living in Cuba. So you've basically got, aside from the dude, you've got the entire cast of friggin' Big Lebowski in the film, which is really strange.
What?
I know. So he gives them a voice box for a Transformer. And they go, Bumblebee, we're going to give you a new voice box. Isn't that brilliant? So he's like, Rrr. So they put the voice box in him. And he goes, and he starts to speak, but it's a woman's voice. He's like, oh, God, no, this isn't my voice. This isn't going to work at all. And just rips it out of his throat. And then he's back to radio stuff. Yet for some reason later in the film, he can talk with his normal voice, but he's got no voice box. How's that work?
Like I said, recordings.
Plot hole!
Yeah,
stupid. Oh, it's just, it's awful.
There's a film we should do a commentary on.
Oh, God, no. I can't watch that again. It was just... It was dreadful, man.
It sounds like it.
Megatron's in it, but I don't even know why.
He just turns up and he's like, hello, I'm Megatron! And then
he picks up Starscream's head at one point because Steve Buscemi bot brings them Starscream's head and goes, look what I found, oh... And then when Megatron turns up at their hideout, he's like, oh, Starscream's head. Oh, he was a knobber, wasn't he?
What?
Basically.
Wait, so Megatron ends up fighting with the Autobots, or what?
No. He didn't do anything.
He just turns up and says, hey, look, I've got this guy's head. He was a dick. And then just
basically, he goes, ah, Starscream, my old friend. And then throws it on the floor. That's literally it.
What?
No. Oh, God, and don't even get me started on Anthony Hopkins and his whole family tree. Apparently Sir Anthony Hopkins is related to Shia LaBeouf.
Okay.
Oh, and yeah, Anthony Hopkins has got a 5-foot-tall Autobot butler with psychopathic tendencies who gets in a submarine with them at some point and decides to go mad and shoots himself out of a torpedo tube. And he's voiced by the butler from fucking Downton Abbey.
Wait, are you being serious?
No, this is real.
What?
I know. He's got a 5-foot butler called Cogman.
Oh my God, what?
I know. And Anthony Hopkins' his family tree, he's descended from the Wiccans.
Right.
Who are the descendants of Merlin. Right. So, apparently Shia LaBeouf is descended from Merlin.
Right.
The Arthurian wizard. Which is why his surname is Witwicky, obviously.
Right.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, yeah, of course, because it was Merlin Witwicky, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was his surname, yeah. When you see Merlin at the very beginning of the film, he's a pisshead. Who goes to the Transformers.
He's like, I saw giant armor! Everyone's like, what?
No, because there's a big, big massive battle, and Arthur and all the knights are like, oh shit, we're going to have to fight all these Saxons or whatever it is that are invading. Oh, bollocks, what's going to happen? And Arthur's like, don't worry, Merlin will sort this out. And everyone's like, Merlin's a fucking knobhead. And you just see Merlin on a hilltop just swigging from a flask going, oh, I'm a pisshead, but I need to sort something out. And he goes to a crashed Autobot ship and goes, hey, give us a hand. He says, I'll give up booze, I'll give up women, I mean, I'll give up booze, just help us out. And then this medieval knight transformer goes, all right then, here's a stick, we'll all transform into a three-headed dragon and help. And that's what happens. And then the last of Merlin's descendants. So presumably Shia Booth's dead at this point. Because the last of Merlin's descendants is Laura Haddock, who you probably know her best as Star-Lord's mum from Guardians.
Right.
Yeah, she's in it. And she plays this Oxford professor. Because, as you know, all Oxford professors are fit movie stars. And she's like this big knowledge on Arthurian legend. Well, it turns out she's only bloody Merlin's descendant, isn't she? And anyone else who picks up Merlin's stick, they just see it as a wooden stick. But if she picks it up, it turns into this big Transformer stick, and she can summon a three-headed dragon. And they use that to fight Cybertron.
What?
And,
so basically...
So you know what? The last film...
What Michael Bay did was like, you know what Transformers needs? Oh, it needs to be the Legend of King Arthur.
Hot Rod's in it, right. Although he's French. What? And he's like, oh, madame, my name is Hot Rod. I am a car. I am a Lamborghini. Ho, ho. And she's just like, why is he French? He's like, I'm not French. I just have the accent. He's just like, she's like, well, why can't he get rid of it? He's like, I don't know how. I do not like the accent.
Wait, he seriously says that?
Yeah.
What?
Like, I can't get rid of it. Because Hot Rod and Bumblebee were mates during the Second World War.
What?
I know. And they fought alongside the Allies to fight the Nazis.
What? No,
and you obviously see a flashback of them fighting Hitler's bunker. And Hitler was killed by a tiny Transformer that turned him over to a pocket watch.
What?
I know, it's stupid.
How? That, what? No, but... In the first Transformers film, you see Bumblebee come to the... How is he there in World War II?
No. But he's there.
What the hell do they transform into?
No, he's like a World War II Jeep or something like that. When he transforms into his robot form, he's still got, like, the wings off the back.
What?
Oh, no, actually, I think he might be, like, an old German VW Beetle at that point. I'm not sure. I think it's Hot Rod who might have been the... Or Hot Rod who might have been the Jeep.
Because so Hot Rod basically back then was fucking Hound?
I don't know. She's saying, what's your name? He's like, Hot Rod. And she's like, what? Hot Rod. And he goes, Hot Rod. He's like, what? And he goes, my name is Hot Rod. And he's like, and friggin' Anthony Hopkins goes, his name is Hot Rod. And he's just, it's like, why is he French? He's like, I don't like being French.
What the hell nonsense is this?
It's stupid. And while she's getting kidnapped by Hot Rod, at one point she realizes it's Transformer and she goes, oh God, which one are you? Are you Soundwave? Shockwave? You know, one of the famous ones. And he's like, shut down and sit down! Ha ha! I will lock you in my trunk!
One of the famous ones!
I know. Soundwave wasn't even famous, he was a satellite up in space, didn't do fuck all.
For fuck's sake.
I know. So it's like the last movie had too much plot in it. Yeah. Where it had like Shockwave coming to Earth, you know, being the Transformer bloody bounty hunter, and yeah, the rebirth of Megatron into Galvatron. That's two movies right there. That's fine. Could have done but either. No, they just shoved them into both into one film. This film has not enough story, and it doesn't make sense.
Yeah,
it's weird. It's a weird film. Oh, and Cogman, for some reason, decides to make them, because they think they're going to die. He shoots himself out of a torpedo tube, somehow gets back into the submarine without depressurizing the entire thing. Meanwhile, Bumblebee's just holding onto the outside as the, you know, so much underwater. Fucking massive, like, the pressure and everything like that would have killed him by this point, but whatever. and but when Cogman's come back in, he's called himself Two Gigantic Fish, and he makes Marky Mark and Laura Haddock, he's made them a nice candlelit dinner in the submarine. I know.
Wait, is Shia LaBeouf in this?
No, you see a photo of him in the wall.
Right.
To show that he's a Wiccan. Well, yeah.
That's what they're called?
Yeah. It's fucking stupid.
Oh, God. This film sounds terrible.
It is.
Is it on Netflix?
It should just be called... Nah. It should just be called Transformers, hopefully the last one. But the new one's coming up with The Rock in it, isn't it? The Bumblebee spin-off film. It's a prequel set in the 80s.
With The Rock?
Yeah.
What?
Well, The Rock says this. The Rock's gonna kick your candy-ass Transformer butt all the way back to Cybertron. If you smell what The Rock is cooking in the 80s.
That is weird.
Yeah. So I saw that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. What else I watched was the new Texas Chainsaw movie.
Okay.
Called Leatherface.
Right.
This is the origin story of Leatherface as a teenager.
What?
Because it's the story we all clamour to know.
Okay.
Starring Stephen Dorff as a copper.
Right.
Lily Taylor as Leatherface's mum. And one of the... it also stars young Hodor.
Right.
You remember old Hold the Door himself? Yep. And it also stars one of the kids who played Ian Beale's son on EastEnders. You know, because he just screams Texas Chainsaw. There's old Ian Beale.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's all about a bunch of kids who are locked up in an asylum. And one night, oh my God, something kicks off at the asylum, and they escape, and take a nurse hostage. And along the way, one of them snaps and becomes Leatherface. Woo!
What?
Yeah, it's crap. Now you know me. You know I like me Texas Chainsaw.
Yeah.
But I just don't understand what. I just don't understand the need for this film. That's like doing a Friday the 13th movie purely about the counselors at Crystal Lake who let Jason drown.
Or like doing a Nightmare on Elm Street film where the entire film is about a paedophile that gets burned.
See, that wouldn't be so bad, but we already know that story. We don't need to see it played out.
Exactly.
We didn't know Leatherface's origin, and that was part of the mystery about him. I didn't need to know anymore. I just needed to know it was a fucked up family who lived in the woods. That's it. All I needed to know, and the first movie showed me that. And the one thing about this movie that really annoyed me the most...
Yeah.
Okay. So you get to see the family around the table. Very first thing you see... Okay. Very first thing you see at the beginning of the film is it's young Leatherface's birthday.
Right.
The kid who goes on to become Leatherface. And sitting around the table are his mum, his brother / possible father, the cook, Drayton Zoya.
Right.
His grandpa... you also see Nubbins, a.k.a. the hitchhiker.
Nubbins.
Okay?
Yeah.
And that's it. Oh, and some dude they've got kidnapped as well, tied up. So my question is, where's Chop Top? Because it is established in Texas Chainsaw 2 that Chop Top is Nubbins' twin brother.
Mm.
Now... He's Chop Top isn't in Texas Chainsaw 1 because he was out in Vietnam at the time. Okay?
Yep.
And in Texas Chainsaw 2, that corpse that they ride around with on top of their van is the corpse of Nubbins. It's the hitchhiker's corpse. So they're not the same person, because a lot of people thought that for a while, That they thought that's why he had his plate in his head, even though he does say in the movie he got it because of Vietnam. So why was Chop Top not in Leatherface? Which is even more confusing because the movie is just called Leatherface, although Texas Chainsaw 3 was called Leatherface, Texas Chainsaw 3. So now there are two Texas Chainsaw movies called Leatherface.
Huh.
Oh, winds me up, man. So, but I've also got the new Cult of Chucky movie, which I haven't watched yet. And I've got It, which I haven't watched yet either.
Oh, I saw It in the cinema.
Any good?
It's good. He's very dribbly.
Well, that's okay.
It's like, no, you'll see what I mean, though. It's like, to be fair, the bit where it's like, Georgie, get down the thing, like, you know how in the original, he just goes, ah, and then it cuts to Pennywise just going, ah, at the camera. It's a bit more brutal this time, to the point where I was like, holy shit.
Well, it's a movie.
Yeah. And there's some of the scenes that work really well. Some of them are a bit weird, but otherwise, it's a fun film.
Mm.
And then, obviously, you'll have seen the memes made out of one of the later scenes.
Oh, the dancing... Yeah. Well, he is Pennywise, the dancing clown.
Yeah.
So, that makes sense to me. Because he was never really shown dancing in the Tim Curry one.
Mm. But, That's... The problem is, though, it's like... Apart from that, and maybe, like, a bit at the beginning, he doesn't really... He acts more terrifying than clown-like, which is why...
Yeah, I suppose Tim Curry did a lot of clown stuff, didn't he?
Yeah.
Hmm.
That's why that scene, once it got to it, I like, when he started dancing, I just laughed and went, the fuck is this? But,
Yeah, a lot of people have said that.
The rest of the film is really good, in my opinion. I mean, it's not like, oh my god, best film ever! But it got around every single argument that I was saying, like, because before I saw it, I was joking, going, if it doesn't have the Prince Albert in a can bit, or
the, well, that's
bit,
when
or
the
balloons,
the
like, the, yeah, that was the thing. I was like, because I didn't know, I just thought, oh, it's a film of It. I didn't realise that this one was going to be entirely the kids. And then there was a chapter two that was entirely adults. And like, just going in, I thought, oh, it's just a feature-length version of, like, the TV thing.
Oh.
And I was like, I don't know how they're going to get all of that in a two-hour film. And then started joking about going, well, if they don't have the Prince Albert in a can joke, and they don't have the bit where the fucking, what was his name? Stan, like, kills himself, and his wife walks in and goes, I'm going to be upset. And
my
then
favorite
they were
scene.
And then they were just like,
as you know,
oh, this is all of them. This entire film is them as kids. I was like, oh, you've just nullified every single jokey argument I had.
Mm.
I wonder if at the very end of the second film he's just going to turn into a giant spider like he did.
I don't know, we'll find out, won't we?
Mm. And he's got to fight the great turtle.
Mm-hmm.
They did include the reference to Pennywise in Dark Tower, though, apparently.
Did they?
Yeah.
I don't think anyone saw Dark Tower, so...
Yeah, because there's a bit where they go past a circus called Pennywise's Circus.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah, because that was always a reference in the books.
In the books, yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh. Interesting.
Mm. So, it was good. I want to go and see the new Blade Runner.
I'm not asked about that at all.
Mm. I'm going to wait for it to be available, like, to watch at home, though, because I mean, I want to rewatch the original Blade Runner first.
Yeah, I think it might even be out of the cinema by now.
Yeah.
Again, no one went to see it.
I'm trying to think of other things. Me and Connor went to see the Lego Ninjago movie.
Any good?
Yeah, quite enjoyed it. And it was really weird, like, watching it, and all the trailers beforehand were for, like, kids' toys and, like, fucking My Little Pony and shit like that.
I mean, I've never knew mine up for any movie ever.
Yeah. And, we were watching the film. It was a bit odd. The one thing I wasn't expecting in it was, like, because it's not really spoilery. It starts with, like, a live-action thing, like the original right. Lego movie had live-action bits.
Yeah.
It uses the live-action thing as a framework, so it's like the beginning and very end thing.
Right.
Of some kid. I can't remember. I'm not entirely sure if it's the same kid or not.
It'd be good if it was. But
going into a shop. The one thing I wasn't expecting was him going into the shop and the shopkeeper being Jackie Chan.
Okay.
Yeah. Because I didn't know who was cast in the film. I was just like, oh, Lego Ninjago film. That's cool. And then they walk in and it's like, and they're like, he turns around, the shopkeeper's Jackie Chan. I was like, what? It's like he's taken over from his his uncle in Jackie Chan Adventures.
Well, let's say he was in the cast. So you've got Jackie Chan as Master Wu.
Yeah. Once he started doing the story, I realized that Jackie Chan was Master Wu, and I was like, oh, okay, that makes sense.
You've got Dave Franco as Lloyd, whoever that is.
Lloyd Garmadon.
Okay, I don't know the characters. Fred Armisen as Cole. Kumail Nanjiani as Jay. Michael Pena. You know that guy who was on my cousin, you know, from Ant-Man? Yeah. Him. Then no one you know. Justin Theroux, who I know for... I think he dated Jennifer Aniston, if I'm not wrong. Olivia Munn. Okay, she played Coco. Randall Park, a.k.a. Kim Jong-il, or Kim Jong-un, whichever one he was, from The Interview. He played Chen, the cheerleader.
Right.
Chris Hardwick was a radio DJ.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
No one. All these people who are no ones. Now that's it. They're the only like names. Which, when you compare it to the Lego Batman movie. Okay, so you've got obviously Will Arnett, Michael Cera, Rosario Dawson, Ralph Fiennes. The Siri woman, Zach Galifianakis, Jenny Slate, Jason Mantzoukas, which, if you watch the league, they're both in that. Jenny Slate's everywhere now at the minute. Conan, Doug Benson, Billy Dee Williams, Zoe Kravitz, Kate McGucci, Ricky Lindholm, they're from Oates and Garfunkel and Oates. Eddie Izzard, Seth Green, Jermaine Clement, Ellie Kemper, Channing Tatum, Jonah Hill, Adam Devine, Hector Elizondo, Mariah Carey. You know, the list goes on. Brent Musburger, Ralph Garman, obviously, Chris Hardwick, Todd Hansen. You know, there's so many people in this movie.
Yeah. I think it also like benefits from the fact that with
obviously Richard Cheese.
Yeah, with Lego, it being based on the Batman from the original Lego movie, and you've got all these characters that you can draw from, whereas Ninjago is obviously, it's going to pretty much draw from just that property. Well, so there's not as much.
The Lego movie itself hasn't actually got that many famous people in it, if you think about it. Got Will Arnett, Elizabeth Banks, Alison Brie, Anthony Daniels, Charlie Day, Will Ferrell, Will Forte, Dave Franco was in it, Morgan Freeman, Jonah Hill, Keegan-Michael Key, okay. Oh, Jake Johnson, yeah. Liam Neeson, Shaquille O'Neal, oh yeah, of course. Nick Offerman.
Yeah, that's why.
Okay, yeah, so there were quite a few.
Whenever anyone says to me, are you all ready for this? I always respond with, oh no, they were ready for that.
Yeah.
Thanks to Shaq being in that.
Yeah, I'm ready for this.
Do, 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 do. Oh no, they were ready for that. That's one of the reasons why, like, the Lego Dimensions ones, because someone was asking me if I'd seen the newer Ghostbusters film, the one with the female team. And I was like, no, but I've played through the Lego Dimensions version of it. So I was like, I know basically the story. And also, I don't know whether it's because it's on Lego Dimensions, but it makes it more enjoyable. Because you've got the other properties from Lego Dimensions, like, crossing over with it. So, like, at the beginning, when they're going to the fucking university where one of them works or whatever, they get cut off in traffic by Doc Brown. There's one bit where they turn up at the fucking subway system, and you can see Saruman and Gandalf, like, busking in the background, like, playing electric guitars. It's really weird.
Well, it's like, have you read Ready Player One?
I've got the audio book of it. It's from the clips that I've seen of, like, pages. It's basically nerdy fan fiction masturbation.
Yes, very much so. But that whole movie is essentially going to be what you're talking about there. Just so much crossing over with each other.
I saw the trailer.
Yeah, we talked about it.
And it was like, yeah. Oh, yeah, we did, because we were talking about, like, there was Deadpool and Harley Quinn in it, and there was fucking A-Team Van and the Iron Giant and...
Yeah, although the Iron
Gandalf,
Giant...
Gandalf, apparently.
Yeah, he chooses a different robot in the book, but apparently in the movie he looks like he's going to choose
the Iron Giant. In the book, it's like a Voltron or something, but they couldn't get the permissions for it, so they changed it to Iron Giant.
Yeah, it's one of them. I think it's actually, I think the robot from Spider-Man, actually.
It was what?
I can't remember. I think it's the robot from Spider-Man. From the Japanese Spider-Man.
Maybe. Let me check.
I can't remember. I'd have to reread the book.
Have you read it then?
Doesn't matter. Yeah, oh yeah. I don't know how they're going to do a hell of a lot of this movie.
Sorry, I was just looking at the thing, and the first thing that popped out at me was, like, oh, the online high school, and then I saw, in a recreation of the Dungeons & Dragons module, Tomb of Horrors. I was like, I can get behind that.
Yes, there's a lot of D&D stuff in this in the book. Yes, you're going
Ultraman.
To...
Ultraman, that's who he uses.
No, it's not.
Oh.
Ultraman is in the movie, but anyway, don't worry about it.
Fuck's sake! I just saw that various characters of Monty Python and the Holy Grail turn up.
Oh no! Right, okay, that means they're doing that scene from the book. Get in.
No, this is me reading about the book.
Oh, right, okay. I thought you meant. Sorry. Yeah. That's it. Whoa. Do not read any more about that book if you've not read it yet.
No, all I know is, like, I knew that they referenced it, like, Monty Python, and I knew they referenced Monty Python stuff, I just wasn't sure which specific film.
Oh,
So I don't know what they're going to do for the film, though. I thought, the way you reacted at first, I was like, shit, did I just spoil something? But I can't have. You just said you read the book.
Yeah.
So I had a bit of a panic there. I'm going to have a listen to it in a bit. Like, currently, I'm do audiobooks I'm listening to. I've been listening to a few different ones. I've been listening to the Magic 2.0 series, which is the whole thing about people figuring out we're in a computer program, so they go back in time to become wizards.
I recommended that to you. I'm sure I did.
My brother did.
Oh, really? Because I'm reading it as well.
Oh, you're reading Magic 2.0?
Yeah.
Nice! Which book are you on?
I think I'm still finishing the first one.
I've finished them all. Fantastic. Oh, are you reading? Yeah. Are you reading them?
Audio book.
Yeah. Because my favourite...
I've almost finished the first book, though.
The only problem, now that I've watched that, whenever anything mentions Merlin, all I can think of is Philip going, Jimmy.
Yeah.
So, I fucking love that set of stories. There's also the Bobbyverse books that I've listened to as well. There's this fella called Bob, who, he's on this, the very beginning of the book, he's sold his company to like Microsoft or whatever for a load of money, and he's in Vegas for this conference, and he's talking to this guy about like cryogenic freezing and stuff, and he signs up for this cryogenic thing, and then the next day, unfortunately, gets killed in a hit and run.
Right.
And then when he wakes up, he is now the AI for a von Neumann probe.
Okay.
So he's been selected to be this AI that runs this probe, so he can get sent out into space, get to different star systems, make copies of himself. And the whole thing is like him making copies of himself and like exploring the stars and shit like that. It's really cool. And the other one I'm reading, the one I'm listening to currently is Expeditionary Force, which is this the whole premise is basically one day we were chilling on Earth and then these aliens turn up and start blowing things up, and then a second race of aliens turns up and destroys the first race of aliens, and so we think we're end up allied with them, and in the middle of this like galactic conflict as foot soldiers, and it's following this one guy called Joe Bishop, who forever from the entirety of the book is basically known as the Barney guy, because the only vehicle that they could find to help fight these aliens and the first aliens was an ice cream truck with Barney the dinosaur drawn on it. Like, this is in the opening chapter, but it's just going through his stories and stuff. It's really interesting. I also listened to one that was like a D&D based one about at the very beginning, this guy got killed by these necromancers for like doing like some crime, and his soul got put in this gem to be used as a slave, but then the necromancers died and the gem fell down into this like underground cave system, but because of like the size of the gem and stuff like that, he lost his memory and he becomes what is known as a dungeon core, which is the whole controlling force behind these big dungeons that like people do dungeon delving and stuff in. So all dungeons that people do dungeon delving in like are run by these dungeon cores that are these little things that spawn the monsters and create loot and stuff for people to get energy for when people die. And it's like all about this guy this thing becoming this dungeon, and like these other people finding it and like creating a town around the dungeon and stuff. It's really cool.
Okay.
I've just been listening to a load of like D&D and sci-fi books, basically.
No, go for it, man. Yeah. Interesting.
I've got the audiobook of Ready Player One. I'm currently listening to The Road as well.
Oh, right, okay.
Which, unfortunately, the book of The Road is a bit more boring than the film. Like, it's because of the way it's told and the narrator fits it, but you can only listen to it in short bursts because it's very monotone.
Right, okay.
I also got 1984 because I was like, I should probably read that again. Brave New World by Aldous Huxley. I've also got the 10th anniversary version of American Gods.
Right.
Yeah. The one by our friend Neil Gaiman.
Right, okay. Neil Gaiman, the gay man.
Do, 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 do.
Neil Gaiman.
Yeah.
He's a gay man.
And this series called Critical Failures, where it's a bunch of friends who like want to run they call it Creatures and Caverns.
Right.
And they invite this the answer this advert to hire this dungeon master, who comes, and it turns out he's got like these magic dice, and they all like start annoying him, so he gives them all, he's like, oh, you can use my special dice, and they all automatically roll a fail and suck the people into the game. So, like, they wake up as their characters.
Right.
And they're like, what the shit? So it's fun. But yeah. Anyway. Yeah, you need to finish listening. You need to listen to Magic 2.0.
I will do.
Off to be the wizard, and then
yeah, that's the one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the second one is Spell or High Water.
Right, that's the one. Yeah, I think there's a fourth one that's just come out or is just about to come out. Maybe.
Oh yeah, yeah. I've listened to all four. Spell or High Water is the second one. An Unwelcome Quest is the third, and then yeah. Fight and Flight is the fourth.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. That's one of the series, like, that and the Bobbyverse, like, as soon as they ended, it's one of those series where I was, like, got to the end, I was like, no, don't end, make another one now! You know, because they are yeah. that good.
So, okay.
What's happened in the book so far from... Spoilers for anyone that's still listening.
Put this else as bloody beyond them, we'll see.
Yeah.
Where am I? I'm up to. They've discovered that think he's a knobhead, basically, with his solid gold castle and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, yeah.
That he's the knobhead. And
they've figured out like about him trying to turn people into hobbits.
Yeah, they know all about his nefarious goings on and all that kind of stuff, trying to manipulate the code for himself and all that kind of gear.
Like it when Philip's like, oh, I came back and I decided to make a quiet life for myself. Jimmy turns up and decides to establish himself as Merlin.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, the guy they've got to do the voice to read the book, he does a good job. I like it.
Yeah, he's a fucking good
I love when the dude goes back to every now and again. We just pops back to the future to pick up like parcels and stuff like that. His mum and dad are just like, "What are you doing?" Every 2 seconds.
Yeah, he's like just walking in, and then he's like,
away. 2 seconds later, he comes back and he's dressed as a, like even grander cloak and all this kind of stuff.
Yeah, with fucking sequins and shit.
Yeah.
And yeah.
That's good. I like the other fella. He's still got his apartment, and he just pops back there. So literally
Todd.
Every 10 seconds he goes to the toilet.
No, not Todd. It's fucking. Oh God, what's in? Which one is it? It's. Shit. Let me just quickly Google it. As soon as I see the name, I'll know who it is.
It's okay. Just every 2 seconds he goes back, and his toilet's been continuously flushing for months or something like that.
Yeah. Oh, it's Tyler.
Right, okay.
I can't remember if it's Tyler or Jeff. I think it's Tyler.
See, I want to say Jeff.
It could be Jeff.
Can't remember. Doesn't matter. Have you seen the...
It's Tyler because Jeff's the one from a little bit further into the future than Martin is.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah. The one with his fancy iPhone thing that he wore.
Yeah, where it's like two sheets of glass.
Yeah,
basically.
That's it. Yeah,
yeah. And he's,
that's it.
And
I love the fact that Thingy's got his Commodore 64, but he uses like a crystal ball and all that.
And then Gary's got the fucking skull cave, and his have they mentioned the fact that his staff basically has the four figures of Kiss just taped to the top?
Yes.
Of
it. Yeah.
One of my favorite parts listening to the first one was how. There were the Magnuses from Norway, who are like metal. But
right.
And when Merlin, when Martin says to Philip, "Oh, they like Gary," and they're like, "No, they judge him." And I was like, "Ah, ha, ha, ha. Metal jokes."
Have you seen the picture of the new Doctor's costume?
Yeah, yeah.
Today, what do you think?
I thought it was pretty cool.
Yeah, it's not bad, is it?
Yeah,
I think she's a little, you know, Rod, Jane, and Freddy. But otherwise, yeah, not bad.
Rod, Jane, and Freddy?
Yeah, you know, Rainbow.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I think she needs to put that coat on properly. It's going to fall off her. But, yeah.
She just turns up dressed as Zippy and George.
I'm forever telling my coat, my kid to put a coat on properly. But so yeah, so she needs to do it properly as well, the doctor. Also, she's got clearly dyed hair because she's got dark roots. So how's that work? She's going to regenerate into someone who's already dyed her hair.
Yeah.
Stupid. But otherwise, yeah, not so bad. She looks a bit mork with the braces and that.
She has braces? Oh, you mean braces. Yeah. I thought you meant like on her teeth.
Suspenders.
I thought you meant on her teeth.
Oh.
I was like, what? You mean braces, not braces.
Yeah. You know what I mean. Braces, not braces. You know.
It just reminds me of...
You wear them while you watch The Omen, not The Omen.
That just reminds me of, like, I was trying to... I read this thing online that was...
No, you didn't.
How do you... trying to explain how difficult the English language is to some people. Like, right. To like, people having to learn it. Because, obviously, most other languages, they have... like, whereas we have the same word but maybe pronounced differently or... like, in a different context, it means something else, and they have completely separate words for it. And written down, it was like, if you don't think English can be a really stupidly difficult language, just remember that read and lead rhyme, and red and lead rhyme, but read and lead don't rhyme, and neither do lead and read.
Oh my god! Dude, we got breaking news.
Oh yeah.
Right, okay. Oh. Coming out to Disney once again.
It's a good thing okay. We kept talking then, isn't it?
It is. It's literally just been confirmed within the last 40 minutes. Okay. Rian Johnson, who's directing the Last Jedi?
Yeah.
As we all know. Yeah. Kathleen Kennedy has said that we all loved working with Rian on The Last Jedi. He's a creative force, and watching him crash The Last Jedi from start to finish was one of the great joys of my career. Rian will do amazing things with the brand canvas of this new trilogy.
Ooh.
Rian Johnson is confirmed to direct a brand new Star Wars trilogy that is separate to the Skywalker saga, and okay. Also Disney are creating a brand new Star Wars live action series.
Huh.
And also a series based on Monsters Inc. and High School Musical. But forget that.
The High School Musical one. Monsters Inc. sounds interesting, but
yeah, they're gonna do a brand new trilogy and a TV series. Oh. Now, whether or not this would be the same TV series that Lucas was working on, because he's got 100 scripts done, ready to go. So we don't know. But
oh, when you were talking about it, I thought you meant that we had new news about the whole Fox buying thing.
No. Star Wars.
No.
Rian Johnson. Yeah, awesomes.
Balls. Yeah.
I like balls. You like balls too. Everybody likes balls. Especially my shoe. My shoe likes balls. Gonna kick you in yours. And you'll fall down. And say, ow. Ow, my balls.
Oh yeah, before we go, I need to play you that fucking drum track, don't I?
Yes, you do. Oh. So what do you think about the whole Star Warsness?
I reckon that could be pretty good. I'm wondering what it could be. Do you know what would be cool? Lando trilogy.
Damn. I'm a space motherfucker.
Then again, he said it was completely separate, so I'm wondering what that would be.
I don't know. Boba Fett. No.
What's that?
Boba Fett?
Maybe. Yeah, but that's still not separate because there's crossover there.
Okay, let's do Jimmy the Hutt.
Jimmy the Hutt, yeah.
Let's see, Jimmy the Hutt. Let's have Barry Cloud Runner.
Barry Cloud.
John Duo. And his mate, Munch Siggy. there's
Honorable Lady Stander.
Yeah, that's Stander. Yeah, spelled E-R, Stander. Yeah. And they're on the run from
the Emporium.
Yeah. Which is and there's a big dude dressed in a big white suit, and his name is
Carl Fathers.
No, his name is Thrad Redav.
Okay.
Yeah. Thrad Redav, that's his name. And yeah. And he has a kill son. Yeah. Which he uses to blow up moons. And all the good guys are part of the what's another word for rebels? The resistance. Oh shit! No, that's what they're called in the film. They're called the... They've stolen both of the names. The people who are against this sort of thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's... Yeah. And there's a bloke there who goes, this may very well be a situation that has been pre-planned by the enemy. Yeah, use a fish. Not the enemy's a fish. I mean, the bloke who says that is a fish. Mm. Yeah, it'd be a bit odd if Thrad Redav was actually a fish. Like, he's got the big suit on and everything, but there's just a goldfish bowl on the top. Catch you! I'll get you, Jamie. What was your name again? Johnny Cloud Runner. I'm a fish. And they fight using bright sticks. Like a moosh moosh.
Moosh. Moosh.
Moosh. Moosh. Fucking moosh! Therefore, opening up a crossover with the Harry Potter universe. See, and that's our idea for the Star Wars spin-off trilogy. So don't steal it, Disney, or we'll cut your teeth out. You hear me, Mickey? I'm going to cut your teeth.
Oh! Oh, no! My teeth!
They've been sliced.
Oh, dear. Pluto, get me yours. I've got no teeth left. Oh!
Why didn't you take mine, Mickey?
Because you're a dick. Have you seen your teeth? You've got two.
Gorsh.
No need to sugarcoat it, huh, Mick? Yuck.
Shut your bitch-ass mouth, Goofy! Why'd you think you don't have Mrs. Goofy anymore?
I had a Mrs. Goofy?
Well, how did you get your son, Max?
I stole him.
I don't know.
Stole him.
I found him on a doorstep. Yuck.
You're Goofy.
I know.
I'm just imagining, like, Goofy is like this child-stealing weirdo now.
Lollipops.
Get in the van, kids. Yup.
Hey, Goofy, what's your surname?
Savile. Yup.
God.
Goofy's fixed it for you.
Oh, gosh.
Say, Goof, you been touching those kids again?
No, Pete, I swear.
Because if you did, I'd have to chop off your nuts.
Gorsh.
This is the first time...
I'd end up like Pluto, you hook?
This is the first time that that Pete has actually been a good guy.
Say, Goof, been rounding up those pedos. Gonna burn them on a fire. You gonna come and watch?
No, Pete. I gotta wash my hair.
You don't have any hair, Goof.
I'm a dog. I'm covered in hair.
My small hat. My small orange hat.
Oh! Okay. See you later. Wonder why his hat takes all night to wash.
I've got a small collection of hats. I wear several a day. Yuck.
So I'm not right about that, Goof. Oh well. People don't know that I'm the same person who voices Winnie the Pooh.
Which is true. He also voiced Scar the Lion very briefly in The Lion King. Jordan, Scar's song, Be Prepared. There's a brief moment where Jeremy Irons' voice isn't in it anymore for some reason. And the guy who does Winnie the Pooh takes over. It's right towards the end of the song. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, be prepared. Because, you know, Nazi hyenas and that. It's a weird film.
Yeah.
Do you reckon they'll keep the Nazi hyenas in the new one?
I don't know.
Jon Favreau's Nazi hyenas.
Be prepared for Nazi hyenas. McLean. I'm Jeremy Irons. You may also know me as Alfred the Butler.
What?
Yes, Jeremy Irons is Alfred the Butler in Batman v Superman and Justice League.
Yeah, fair point.
Yeah, see, yeah. Didn't think about that, did you?
I completely forgot about it.
Yes.
So be prepared for Batman to drink his own weight in booze. I killed Darth Vader.
Oh, God. Alfred the Butler killed Darth Vader?
Jeez.
Jesus. He really was a badass, wasn't he? This must have been Earth One Alfred, clearly.
Mm.
Yeah?
Master Wayne, do you remember the time that we were in on the savannah, on the plains of Africa, and I killed Darth Vader?
No.
Yes, I was a lion then, you see.
What are you on about, Alfred? Well, you can be a Batman, I can be a lion. No, but I only dress in a costume.
Unfortunately, I lost that life when I fell into a cave and then ended up being worn by the son of Zeus as a cape.
What's the one thing I taught you to do, young Bruce Wayne?
Huh?
Be prepared! Now, hurry, we must go quick. Cheech Marin and Whoopi Goldberg are coming for dinner.
What? Oh, yeah. I got really fucking confused. It's like a really random, just fucking.
Watch some Gossip Gertie from the Schumacher movies. Coming for dinner tonight at Stately Wayne Manor, Whoopi Goldberg and Cheech Marin. Hey, we're just happy to cameo in this movie, is it? Anytime you need a Mexican, you know, you get me. Or mariachi. Machete. Mariachi. Hello, Danny Trejo is busy.
And so we got these guys.
You know, mariachi in space. In space, no one can hear your flamenco.
God.
That's Spanish. I don't care. I'm going to hang out with Batman tonight, yo. And Scar. Anyway.
That got a bit bizarre.
Yeah. Tell me, Master Wayne, do you remember what happened to young Simba? His parents were killed in an alley by Joe Chill. So be prepared!
Star Wars trilogy done.
Jeremy Irons is.
I don't know why, but I was just going to be. His overarching character is Jacques Cousteau. I was like, why? Does that even make any sense? Follow me into the sea and remember what I always say: be prepared. Get in my transforming car. I am odd and odd.
I'm a black car. Oh, be prepared.
Jesus Christ.
So, yeah, Disney, don't steal our ideas.
I think our ideas are too fucking weird.
Simon says, McLean, be prepared.
Imagine Han Solo and see Luke Skywalker. Oh no, how do we blow off this Death Star?
Well, I've got all this water, I've got a 10-gallon jug, a 3-gallon jug, and a 5-gallon jug.
Yeah, yeah.
We have to use these two to fill up that one. But how? Where'd you come from, Princess Leia?
I'm not Leia, I'm Mickey Mouse! Oh, God. Jesus Christ, man.
Mm-hmm.
Play me this music.
Okay, so this is the one.
Are
song.
You prepared?
Right. There's no guitar on it yet, it's just fucking drums and samples.
G-guns.
Yeah.
Robocop, get his arm blown off.
Yep.
I've got a 2-year-old to rape on Tuesday.
Jesus!
Former lead singer with the Welsh rock group Lost Prophets pleaded guilty to a string of sex offences, including the attempted rape of a baby. Cardiff Crown Court heard that Ian Watkins.
What is wrong with you, man?
What? Yeah, there you go. What did you say?
I said you're a bit mad, you.
Well, I've got another one that you'll appreciate the samples of.
Why can we no longer think of the British Isles without the word pedo in front of them?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Yeah.
That reminds me. I've left that letter T on auto on my typewriter.
Yeah.
I've got a song for you.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yep.
For the cool of the century, be prepared for the murkiest scam. Meticulous planning, tenacity spanning, decades of denial is simply vile. The king undisputed, respected, saluted, and seen for the wonder I am. Yes, my teeth and ambitions are bad. Be prepared.
There you go.
This is why I was trying to talk the writers of the fucking pantomime this year, because it was Aladdin. I was like, if I get to be the genie, can I sing the well, Alibaba had them 40 thieves,
and they're like, copyright.
Yeah, they were like, yeah, no, you can't do that, copyright. I'm like, shit. So I've apparently got to sing Razzle Dazzle.
Let's see.
Because the line is, oh, we've got to give him a bit of razzle dazzle, and then it goes into like, give him the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle. I'm debating actually doing that voice for the song.
Okay.
And then at the very end, like, me and Abby stood there doing jazz hands at Aladdin. But yeah, you know, whatever.
Let's see. Let's see if I can find you a better song. let's see. There we go. We found a song here by a popular little beat combo I've never heard of before. Upper West featuring Skizzy Mars. Let's see what song they've got to play. So far, so panto.
Sometimes I could be your lover, but I really like you better as a friend. And I think you will discover that we kind of be together in the end. See, I kind of like you, it's just I don't really want to settle down. And we're kind of different, you know, you're sitting in from a little town. You could be my friend with the benefit, we could just have fun for the hell of it. Unintelligent for you to go and tell a friend of me you're working, and we're talking about settling. Don't think I'm in love with you, and I'll be gone in a month or two. So you should go and find another dude that wants something more. I just tell the truth, like, I enjoy your company, but seemingly not want to be the type to say I'm okay today and stay if I really, really want to leave. So I prefer this non-committal.
You
just be friends for little. Thing on the side, let me know on your side if you want to turn FWB, alright?
I really enjoyed what we did last night.
Got do
I regret that we crossed that line? No. And I am just wondering why.
So yeah, friends with benefits.
I could do this Finish one. Yeah? Hold on.
Come on, I was born ready.
Okay. Boom. Big Shaq, Ota Asni, Scoop Nu, Rat Nu, Usna, Ota the girl as well. Boom. 2 + 2 = 4, -1, that's 3, quick maths. Everyday man's on the block, smoke trees. See your girl in the park, that girl was a uckers. When the thing went quack, 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 you man were ducking. Ota Asni, he's got a pumpy.
I could sing this.
Yep.
Moving that cornflakes. Rice Krispie. On the road doing 10 toes. Lama toes. You man, four, I froze. I see a peng girl, then I pose. If she's not
peng. A ghost. What's hey. A peng?
Look at your nose. What? You dickhead? Look at your nose. Nose long like garden.
Look out your nose.
Look at your nose.
Boom. Man's gonna come back in. Yeah. You know like that? Yeah, yeah, you're feeling that.
Yeah, but
it's
done.
Yeah. Like shivering and that. Don't get shook, man's ear. You're protected. Right. Yeah?
Alright,
boom. Let's go. Boom. Up at the four door with the 4-4, it was 1, 2, 3, and 4.
What is this?
Chilling in the corridor.
Big Shaq. Man's not hot.
Alright, okay. Yeah, I've got another song for you, Panto.
Yeah.
Okay, you ready?
Okay.
Move, bitch! Get out the way! Get out the way, bitch! Get out the way! Move, bitch! Get out the way! Get out the way, bitch! Get out the way!
Sing that to Abby.
Yeah. Oh, this one should work for Aladdin.
You're walking in the woods. There's no one around and your phone is dead. Out of the corner of your eye, you spot him.
Shia LaBeouf.
He's following you, about 30 feet back. He gets down on all fours and breaks into a sprint. He's gaining on you.
Shia LaBeouf.
You're looking for your car, but you're all turned around. He's almost upon you now, and you can see there's blood on his face. My God, there's blood everywhere.
Running for your life from Shia LaBeouf. He's brandishing a knife. It's Shia LaBeouf. Lurking in the shadows. Hollywood superstar Shia LaBeouf. Living in the woods.
Do you reckon that would work?
But you're hopelessly lost yourself.
Was that not?
Stranded with a murderer.
Would it work? Probably. Possibly.
Oh, I know which song I should sing. This one.
I don't know.
Do you know what's that?
Is that lovely?
Yeah. Just imagine that, like, fucking Aladdin. I've got the perfect song for this, Aladdin. Grab my terry folds. Grab my foldy flaps.
I'm Mr. Macy. Look at me. I'm Mr. Macy. Yes, sir.
You make a request. The Macy fulfills the request. And then it stops existing.
Oh my God! If you're the genie,
yeah,
could you call yourself Mr. Meeseeks? So every time you appear, you go, "I'm Mr. Meeseeks. Look at me."
Well, so like I could probably throw that in. I could probably throw a Meeseeks reference in there. Just when
I'm the genie. Look at me.
No, when Aladdin says, "Oh, I wish to be this," I'm like, rather than going, "Wish granted," I could go. Can do!
Can do!
I've just realised what I should sing.
Shut up, Mr. Meeseeks.
Hi, Barry Scott here, asking whether you have problems with limescale, rust, ground bean dust. They're a challenge for some household cleaners, but not a silly bang. Silly bang, silly bang, silly, silly, silly bang, silly bang.
I could do that. Yeah, Yeah, I could probably sneak a Meeseeks reference in there.
Yeah, could you do this?
Hello.
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 It's me.
Hey, Peter.
Hello.
Hello.
Can you hear me? I was wondering if after all these years you'd like to meet.
Hey.
Hello.
Anthony.
Can you hear me? I'm in California dreaming about
what is that on the top of it?
You never seen this man in
no.
This girl's man.
I've
forgotten how it felt before the world fell.
There's
such a difference between us and the million.
Fucking hell,
just
been
shot with. Oh, you need to see the smacking in the entry first of all.
Yeah,
and then
yeah.
You have to watch that. Oh, it's amazing. I'll find you a link and I'll send it to you.
Okay. I've got this one.
You literally just, I've just googled that exact same song, you dick.
I don't want to watch. There's stuff about insects.
What, shipping and receiving?
So I reach for the remote control, but all I think about is hot sex. I never see you gonna reach for it, so I try to pass it to you. Touch for the first time, but hopefully not the last. It's true. I blush, you blush, we both blush, and I get an erection when I show some affection.
I forgot that you even knew that song existed.
Right, so there's the smackhead. There's the...
I'm in it!
I'm trying to find that. Is it?
Hello?
Oh, I forgot six. I'll find it.
I'll go away, you know.
Yeah, I'll get a song for you.
Okay.
Just wait for it to load. Come on.
I'm sure I can get away with it.
At the gay bar.
I've got one. Hold on. Bustin' me.
There you go. Let's do that one.
Ah.
Yeah, here's one for you, mate. It's only a short one. Okay, ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Leave Benny alone! Please!
We go. That's it.
This is one we should do. I don't know if I can get away with that, though. Oh.
Oh, we are. It's the best one for you when you come out.
Yep.
Oh, do I not have this?
Airwaves in a bottle.
Don't say that.
So you can always keep that kick handy.
If you want, I mean, come on, dude. Come on, shit. Rick rolled on a podcast. Imagine you coming out, giving it all the do-do-do.
Yeah.
We're no strangers to love.
I've got one that I could.
You know the rules, and so do I. And so on.
I've got one.
Is that fucking Happy Town?
Lazy Town, yeah.
Lazy Town, whatever.
Just wait.
You ready?
Yep.
See, that's all I've been. You? I'd love to see you doing that on in the panto.
Oh, I've got an even better one.
You on?
Sorry. I'm
just... Hey. One mountain. Come on. £1 fish. £1 fish. What's that fish?
He's got a fucking music video for it now.
You're messing.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, £1 Fishman TV.
Brilliant.
Listen.
Hey. £1 fish. £1 fish. Hey, Billy.
It's just him, like, dancing around in a dance studio with a load of different ladies.
Brilliant. Yeah, here's one for you. Never heard the verse for this. Or if it's in English. On a bike.
Well, if we're going stuff like that, I could always just go the full.
If we're doing this, we're doing it right. Here we go. 7 a.m. waking up in the morning. Oh, gotta go downstairs. Gotta have my bowl, gotta have cereal. Seeing everything, the time is cold. It's Cyberman trying to sing. Everybody's rushing. Gotta get down to the bus stop. Gotta catch my bus. And see my friend. Kicking in the front seat. Sitting in the back seat. Gotta make my mind up. We feel it when I do. Come on. What's your favourite day, Andy? Let me know. Is it
Friday?
Getting down on Friday. You looking forward to the weekend? Friday. Yeah. Yeah. Run. Love it. Looking forward to the weekend, me. Oh. Maya.
I've got this.
Oh, I've got one for you.
Anyway.
Yeah. This one.
Yep. Yo, listen up. I was talking about Eiffel 65 the other day at work.
Because everyone's... This is one of those bands where everyone's like, hey, do you remember that band that did that song Blue? And I'm like, of course I do. I bought the album Europop. Everyone's
I bought the single.
Well, I've got the single of Move Your Body, and I've got the entire album, Euro.
Move your body, come on now, move your body. Yeah. Move your body, everybody.
Because they had the song on there about PlayStation. If I'm a genie and wearing stuff, so I kind of look like the genie from Aladdin, I will totally, like, throw in a reference to this.
Well, if you're blue, you've got to be Meeseeks.
Well, I'm doing both, remember?
That's very true.
I'll say, like, I'm blue, dabbity. And then later on, when he's asking for a wish, it's like, ooh, we can do!
Can do!
But yeah, I was talking about Eiffel 65 at work the other day.
Cause... Hey, man, I don't give a crap about myself, Rick. Let's watch some crazy stuff, yo! I'm Anson My Eyes Johnson here at Anson My Eyes Johnson's Electronics. I mean, there's so many ants in my eyes, and there's so many TVs, microwaves, radios. I'm not 100% sure what we have here in stock because I can't see anything. Our prices, I hope, aren't too low. Check out this refrigerator, only $200. What about this microwave? Only $100. That's fair. I'm Anson My Eyes Johnson. Everything's black. I can't see a thing, and also I can't feel anything either. Did I mention that? But that's not as catchy as having ants in your eyes, so that always goes, you know, off by the wayside. I can't feel. It's a very rare disease. All my nerves, they don't allow for the sensation of touch. So I never know what's going on. Am I standing, sitting? I don't know.
There you go. No songs wanted to play that. It's because I love Anson My Eyes Johnson. As you were. Yeah, here's another one for you.
I'm Anson My Eyes.
Gus!
I'm Anson My Eyes.
Gus!
Oh yeah, I was talking to Connor and like I need to show him actual wrestling. Because he keeps doing that. He's like, you can't see me. I'm like, why? And he's like, because I'm John Cena. Do, 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 do. I'm like, have you watched anything? Watched any wrestling? He's like, no. I'm like, okay, you need to actually see some wrestling. And then you'll appreciate that more. Yeah, next time he says, you can't see me, I'll be like, no, I can't because I'm Anson My Eyes Johnson.
And also, I can't touch. So smack him in the face and go, did I touch you? I don't know. I'm on some hairs, Johnson.
Get your shit together.
Yeah, put it all in a bag.
Right. Anyway, we should probably end this call. We've just started doing nothing but ramble.
Yes, true. But still, it's been funny.
Yes, it has. Okay. So this is just a random beyond?
Yeah, probably. Just find a way to finish it after the Disney.
I'll like get the little no, because the Disney thing evolved into a. Well, I'll put a clip of the Disney thing at the end of the.
At the end of the Disney thing is just, you know, we'll cut it there and then figure out a starting point for this.
Well, no. What I was thinking was like as the post credits clip of the other one, I can put like the thing where you're like, oh, breaking news, this. And then we start talking about it, and then be like, if you want to continue with this conversation, listen to the Beyond the 50.
Well, I'll just record some a post-credits clip for that now. Okay, you ready? Okay. Hold on a minute. I'm sure there was some more breaking news. In fact, there was! So if you want to find out what the breaking news was, you'll have to listen to our next episode, which is a Beyond, but it does have a bit of news in there. I promise. And some other weird stuff. So be prepared!
Always remember that, Batman.
Remember, Batman, to be prepared. Drink your wine.
Would you like a biscuit, fucking Cheech?
Cheech. Only!
Right, okay, there's your post-credits clip for that. Yeah, and we'll leave that in this episode so people can hear it.
Would you like would you like a biscuit, Whoopi? That was what I was trying to say.
Whoopi!
Whoopi!
I can't do a Whoopi Goldberg, so that's why she never spoke. Right, okay, well, we'll end this here. So, usual rules apply. 50-foot nerds on the Twitter, at Mike G. Bell, at Vault of Extol, at Auton Scouser. You know it all. You've heard it all before. And if you haven't, go back and listen to one of the other episodes because I can't be bothered saying it all now.
Yep.
For this episode, I've been prepared.
Damn it. And I don't fucking know.
You're Mr. Meeseeks, look at you.
Yeah, look at me.
Until next time.
I've been blue.
Until next time. How do we end beyond? Come on, that's your...
Shalom, motherfucker. Bang.
There you go. See ya. It's a piece of cake, it's like a pretty cake. If the way is hazy, you gotta do the cooking by the book. You know you can't be lazy. Never use a messy recipe. The cake will end up crazy. If you do the cooking by the book, then you'll have a... Hey, break it down, bitch! Let me see you back it up! Drop that ass down, load it, pick that motherfucker up! Oh, break it down, bitch! Let me see you back it up! Drop that ass down, load it, pick that motherfucker up! Now back that pussy, she's a motherfucker! Hey, back that pussy, she's a motherfucker! Now back that pussy, she's a motherfucker! Hey, back that pussy, she's a motherfucker! It's a piece of cake, it's a pretty cake! What? If the way is hazy, hey, you gotta do the cooking by the book! What? You know you can't be lazy! Yeah. Never use a messy recipe! What? The cake will end up crazy! Hey. It's yours, bitch. Grab it, dick. It's yours, bitch. Rub that shit. It's yours, bitch. Grab it, dick. It's yours, bitch. Turn around, bitch. Put that ass on the nigga. Grind on the dick. Make it get a little better. Now turn around, bitch. Put that ass on the nigga. Just grind on the dick. Get take out the nigga. You gotta do the cooking by the book. Yeah. I forgot that it was me that did that. Yeah. Shalom. I can't even remember where that came from now.
It's because we were trying to figure out how to end an episode once and I just screamed, Shalom, motherfucker, bang! And then we just ended it there.
No, but I'm sure it came out of something originally. But
yeah, it was the whole thing about Mel Gibson being like a suicidal fucking...
Oh, something like that, yeah.
He was like a Jewish suicide
bomber. I knew it was something to do with like a Jewish suicide bomber, but I can't remember how
it was. Like Mel Gibson probably one making a film about it.
It was probably from one of the nights when I was on patrol and I was bored and we phoned each other at like stupid o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and he kept me company while I was walking around in the middle of the night.
Yeah, I was just like we came up with this entire fucking film.
Yeah.
I'm like, Shalom, motherfucker, bang!
Who's the Hawkeye of the Bible?
Yeah.
Yeah. That'll be where it come from, then. The Hawkeye of the Bible. Anyway. Right, I'll let you go. You've got two episodes to do, so
yeah.
Have fun. All right. Take it easy, Chief.
Soon. Okay.
And I'll speak to you soon.
Okay, talk to you later.
I'll write a Christmas script and we'll get that done.
Awesome. I'll finish.
So be prepared. Right.
I will be prepared.
And all right. Ciao, Chief.
All right. See ya. Bye.
Bye.
The post-credits clip that we recorded that was supposed to go at the end of the Fox special, you may not remember that actually being there. That's because I forgot it existed. Oh well. So it's here for you to enjoy. Any complaints, just email us at 50footnerds@gmail.com. Break it down, bitch.